If we right-click on our picture or our graphic, it brings up the context menu, or the right-click menu, as some people like to call it. First thing in there is a range. We saw this bring to front and send to back, where it just brings our graphic in the front of multiple graphics. Same thing for these next two, which is send backwards and bring forward. If we have multiple graphics, bring forward means one level up. Alignment, we saw that. Anchor, we talked about that. Wrap, we've seen no wrap. We've seen the page wrap. Optimal page wrap. That just means put the text on the side that has more space. So if the graphic is more on the right, it puts the text on the left. If the graphic is more on the left, it puts the text on the right. Wrap through, we saw that. And now we see in background. And if we put it in the background, if I turn on my picture toolbar, we can make this a watermark, and it is actually behind the text there. Before we get to contour, let's go back to page wrap. And we can see that the text here along the sides shows that this looks like a box. If I change this to contour, we see that the text comes in from the sides and wraps around this circle. I'm going to turn off the contour and go back into Edit Contour. We see the icons along the top, which allow us to select our own contour. Let's say that I want to make this the circle. And now I want to move it around, so I'm going to click on the arrow to select it. I've got green dots that allow me to make this bigger or smaller. So now I've got it in a circle, but outside are these little square corners that didn't quite make it in. But this is good enough for me. I'm going to click check to say yes, I like it. And when I close and look at it, I can see that it looks similar to what we did when we just clicked the contour. But if I go in and edit it again, edit contour, I'm going to select the rectangle. And now, I've selected that wallet. It's deselected what was selected. So the wallet itself now is deselected, but these corners that were not selected before are now selected. So it does the inverse of what it was. I'm going to click the check mark, apply. And now when we see, we've got text on the left and in the middle where I removed the selection. And here we can see the two corners that were not visible a few minutes ago. And now you can go crazier by adding another circle inside. What I'm getting at is this really allows you to be creative with your graphics. Going to undo those. Thank you.